things that a traveler may see. She may see from a hilltop the entire Imperial fleet. She may see a parrot at last and find out if it really can talk like a person. Pilgrims, vagabonds, minstrels and clowns. She may see her father again. Wonder in the eyes of other ladies as they notice the difference between her fine clothes and the homespun on the man who rides with her. She may look behind and see the palace dwindling in tearful sight. She may see countless bandits pouring from the woods on each side of the road. Confusion, fear, homesickness and shame. She may see the perfect companion.
Sir Shonagon, we may be losing you.
Losing me?
Of course, it is only a rumour, and there are often many false ones scuttling around the palace.
Where did you hear this rumour?
Ah, but it was told to me in confidence.
False rumours often are, Narimasa.
It is false, then. You have no plans to leave with our brave lieutenant?
I have no such plans.
It might do you good.
Might it?
Your soul, woman. It would be good for your soul to live for a while without luxury.
You don't abstain from the fine things of life yourself?
In moderation. That is the proper mindful way. But you seem perpetually adrift in vanity and frivolity.
I am not adrift. I know where I am.
You might be better down on your knees for a while. If not in prayer, then scrubbing a floor. Pluck a few chickens instead of scribbling in your book of trivial secrets. Ah, Yukinari. We were just talking about you and the fascinating, worthy life you lead.
Narimasa, I seem always to be interrupting you and this lady.
You come to her room so often.
To find you causing her distress.
Does she look in distress? She looks to me as complacent and haughty as ever.
Go away.
How dare you?
Leave my room, Narimasa.
I am the priest of this palace.
Go away, priest.
You will regret this, policeman. And you will regret not seeking my help to solve these crimes.
Never fear. You will have your part to play before this is over. Forgive me, Shonagon.
Not at all. I enjoyed that immensely. I should tell you there is a rumour.
About us? Already? This place is worse than my village. I'm here to tell you Lord Tadanobu has asked to see me. In the garden where the footprints were found.
In the garden? But why?
I wondered if you could tell me. He sent word that I was not to bring you.
He has warned me against...
Against me.
Don't lose your heart. He said. I'll come with you. One of the things he said he admired in me was my independent spirit, so we'll meet him together. Do we tell him?
That we know who the criminal is. If we may call him a criminal.
I sent for you and you alone.
Shonagon is here by her own will and my wish.
You wish her to see your humiliation very well and may persuade her not to go wandering off with a bedmaker's son.
Is it so important to you that I stay here, Lord Tadanobu?
It is. You are not the only one whose heart can be lost.
My lord.
Yes. Confession. And here's another. My ancestors were warriors, Yukinari.
Is that a cause for confession?
These days, yes. Warriors are considered not much higher than mercenaries or policemen. My family has risen above such brutal things. Generations ago we rose. But in my youth, I confess, I saw the old days as romantic glory. I read the old tales and imagined new ones for myself. And I made a pilgrimage to the hills behind Mitaki to meet Kambe, who made this sword for me.
My lord, no.
And the master himself taught me to use it.
The village blacksmith made mine.
Yukinari!
My father was outraged at the small fortune I paid for this blade.
Mine cost a bedstead and 3 sacks of rice. My father was happy enough with the trade. He even taught me to use it.
Yukinari, please.
I will not kill you, but you will be marked. You will be humiliated. Prepare. I said prepare.
This is me, prepare.
Vulgarian!
A woman in my position. Hands and feet and heart are cold. She could run into the palace, fetch the guards. She must not do that. She's not sure she could move at all. She knows men are dangerous fools. She knows how glorious a fool can be. She thinks he will win. She thinks he will win. She wishes there was some way both could lose. Her shoes would be ruined standing so long in the unmoving snow. Someone surely must hear all this. It is like a dance. He is a clumsy dancer. Those wind chimes ring like mockery. She ought to cry out. Stop, stop, stop. She can no more speak than move. Cold dampness seeps up her stockings. They'll be ruined too. It is like a dance of lunatics. If she could find her voice, would she scream or cry out exultantly? And why this urge to laugh? No one will be killed. That has been promised. But their blood is hot now. Promises melt in hot blood.
Stand still. If you stand completely still, you will not be marked.
Your father taught you well.
Yes. It's a country style and clumsy, but I usually win. Now, listen. Shonagon will decide if she leaves or stays. Not you, not I. She decides.
She is a woman of independent mind.
She is. I certainly will be leaving soon. I know who the thief is. He is young and bold and strong. He's clever. He's a trickster. He loves riddles and games. He's young enough to love stories about brigands and heroes. His ancestors were warriors too. He's been known to stand on a giant snowball and sing about them.
But that's
unthinkable.
Nothing is unthinkable.
But it is unsayable. Understand?
So, good Yukinari, you know the name of our masterful villain.
I believe I do, Your Majesty. And I suspect His Majesty knows it too.
I have known from the beginning. He is cunning, is he not? And bold?
Indeed.
I was told you too were cunning and insightful. That's why I brought you here for the game of it.
What game, Your Majesty?
Your Majesty, do we expose the culprit?
Of course we expose him. And his punishment must be extreme.
Narimasa, your zeal does delight me.
If I might make a suggestion.
Do?
Narimasa has been right all along.
Has he?
Before the name of the culprit is given out, if His Majesty chooses to do so, what we need is an exorcism.
Yes, a thorough exorcism and extreme retribution.
Thorough indeed. It must be the ritual of the 40 hungry days.
40 hungry days?
And no priest but Narimasa is devout enough to carry that out.
What ritual is that?
His Majesty knows.
Of course I do. The ritual takes 40 days and nights. 300 sutras must be copied.
Your Majesty, is it not 500?
You are right as always, clever Shonagon. 500 sutras, copied and copied again, spoken in a whisper as you write.
An almost inaudible whisper.
During that time, the exorcist must only have one cup of water a day and eat only every third day one bowl of rice. Or is it two?
I think it is one large bowl.
Yes, one bowl only, but quite a large one.
Your Majesty!
Oh, Narimasa, your zeal and devoutness will delight me again.
It was at my bedside when I woke this morning. As good as new and exactly in tune. Whoever stole it has kept it safe.
I am happy for you, Your Majesty. And for the loot.
The Emperor tells me Yukinari knows who the thief is.
He does, yes.
And if her lieutenant knows, so must Shonagon. That's all right. His Majesty says he will tell me in 40 days' time, and he assures me there'll be no more crimes.
We can be confident of that, I think.
You have grown fond of the lieutenant.
He possesses, as the Emperor said, cunning and insight. And he's as subtle as he is clumsy.
He makes you smile. A policeman's life is a hard one. He will not always be solving little thefts in a palace. The wife of such a man would not have an easy life either.
No, Your Majesty, but perhaps an interesting one.
His salary will not be very great.
I believe it is reasonable.
Could my Shonagon live on reasonable? He will receive an excellent payment from His Majesty, but it won't last forever.
There is my poetry. I would certainly continue with that. And Lord Tadanobu thinks lords and ladies would commission me to write. And there's my pillow book, my lists.
Would you give away our secrets?
No, Your Majesty. I would be very discreet.
I think you're more likely to be indiscreet in a subtle and charming way. And where would you live?
I don't know. In his village.
Shonagon and village life. What a pillow book that would make. And when he's away on some mission or other. Could you bear to be alone in your village? But maybe you'll have children.
No, Your Majesty, no.
Oh, I am sorry.
Do not be, please. The absence of children is no loss to me.
And Yukinari, might he not want a family? He's young enough still. Has he any of his own now?
He had one son, who lived only weeks after his wife died giving birth.
Oh, Shonagon.
It was a long time ago. And when he's away from home, I could go with him, help him with his investigations.
Yes, that would make for interesting times. Shonagon and Yukinari, they might become legends. I shall miss you, Shonagon.
I have not made up my mind.
But I think you have lost your heart. Yes, I shall miss you deeply. No other of my ladies amuses me nearly so much, as I'm sure you know. Oh, I suppose you could send me copies of your lists, but it wouldn't be the same as hearing your voice. No one else in the palace can be so perfectly polite and at the same time so utterly devastating, not even Lord Tadanobu. I think you would miss me too. A smile and a tear. You have lost your heart.
I cannot leave my Empress. Not yet.
I understand.
I lost my heart to her a long time ago.
When you saw her hands, the loveliest things you'd ever seen. I do understand. I feel the same about your eyes.
I, too, understand you.
Recognition.
Yes. We saw and knew each other.
We see and know each other. Goodbye, my Shonagon.
Things I know about this man. Out there, he will fight real, horrible crimes as a knight will face a dragon. Sometimes he will blunder and make powerful enemies. He will make enemies by not blundering at all. I know his friends will laugh at the stories about our strange ways here. I know he will speak about me only with respect and that smile of his. He will not marry again. He looks poor, but noble on that old horse. Poor, noble, brave, inelegant. He has the heart of a poet, but not the talent. Clever, compassionate, irreverent, patient. He would be a gentle and considerate lover. It is not only devotion to my Empress that keeps me here. It is fear of out there. I know he knows this. And this, too, I know. He will come back to me.
In The Pillow Book by Robert Forrest, Shonagon was played by Ruth Gemmell, Yukinari by Mark Bazeley, The Emperor by Richard Madden, The Empress by Laura Rees, Tadanobu by Benedict Cumberbatch, Tazami by Colette O'Neill, Narimasa by John Rowe, and Seisho by Caroline Martin. The Pillow Book was inspired by the diary of Say Shonagon. It was written by Robert Forrest and directed by Lu Kemp.